were scared that you wouldn't show.
Yeah, I wasn't sure how to respond to a bunch of pap smear sticks that spelled out water cooler 4 on my desk. A little murdery, if I'm being honest.
Oh, sorry for being so cryptic. We just didn't want this to be a public affair.
Well, then why are we meeting in front of a water cooler?
Oh, well, we thought that if we met in the corner of a room or like a broom closet or something, that would be way better. So this is really quite the kind of thing.
But we're getting away from the point. You're probably wondering why we called you.
I thought I was hiding my confusion so well.
That is no time for cracking jokes. We called you here because your services as a Lake Lakota County OBGYN have been less than stellar.
Seth, this is an intervention.
Oh, I know what this is about. You think because I'm a man, I can't be an OBGYN. Well, I'll have all of you know.
Chill, man. This is not an attack on your gender. This is an attack on your skills.
How could you, Rob? I thought we were OBGYs. Not me. I mean, I know I've made a couple mistakes, but I'm not that bad. What have I done? Where's the evidence?
You call the cervix a curvix, and when a female patient tried to correct you, you said, and I quote, "You're wrong because I'm a doctor and you're just a woman who never took anatomy."
Okay, but that was one time.
I've been telling patients who come in on their period that they have severe intestinal bleeding and they will seek emergency medical treatment immediately.
It could happen.
You've been putting on puppet shows with your speculums. You should have named one Specky the Speculum.
All right, I'm doing that one. All right, I'll take what you've done into consideration, but I have a 2:30 I need to get to before they get in. Patient.
Cute. Actually, Seth, we were more thinking that you would take an indefinite leave of absence.
My assistant Margo has scattered your things and packed your car, and Jane will take care of your 2:30.
Don't think of this as a loss. Think of this as a win for all of your patients.
You can't do this to me.
Oh, we can, and we have.
Can I just make one last request?
Here's Specky and his friend Speckman.
I guess we'll be going then.
As he should have years ago. All right, guys, it's 2:30, so I'm going to go look at Miss Whitney's curvix. Ta-ta.